Building wall 6 meter long and 5 meter high is built up as follows. Inside 20 centimeter tile which has thermal conductivity of 10 watt per meter Kelvin, and outside 10 centimeter brick which has thermal conductivity of 15 watt per meter Kelvin. In between these two layers there is an air gap which has thermal resistance of 0.233 Kelvin per watt. Find the rate of heat transfer through the wall if the inside face temperature is 30 degree centigrade and the outside temperature is 10 degree centigrade, and the options are 5 watts, 100 watts, 85 watts and 50 watts. Coming to the solution, the overall heat transfer through a wall is given by the change in temperature between inside and outside surfaces, that is, let us say delta T, and the overall thermal resistance of the wall. Here we have three types of resistance. One is inside we have a material of tile which has a thickness of 20 centimeter and which has a thermal conductivity of 10 watt per meter Kelvin. It has some resistance, and we have some resistance by air in between the layers, and we have some resistance due to the outside surface, that is 10 centimeters brick. So we can write it in the formula, that is the outside temperature, the change in temperature between the outside and inside, that is, let us say T1 minus T2, and thermal resistance for the wall is given by thickness of the wall by thermal conductivity of the wall into area, surface area of the wall plus, and we have thermal resistance of air, and we have the outside thermal resistance, and which is also a wall, and is given by the outside thickness of the wall by thermal conductivity of the wall into A. Let us say this is for brick, and let us say this is for tiles. So by substituting all the values, we can get here the overall heat transfer is 85.5 watts. Here the surface area of the two walls is same, that is 6 meter long and 5 meter high, then surface area is equal to 6 into 5, that is 30 meter square, and thermal conductivity of the tile is 10 watt per meter Kelvin, and thermal conductivity of the brick is 15 watt per meter Kelvin, and thermal resistance of air is 0.233 Kelvin per watt, and the change in temperature between the inside surface and outside surface is given by 30 minus 20, and we get here 85.5 watts, and in the options the correct option is C, that is 85. Steam condenser being cooled by water has been designed on the assumption of clean water and having overall heat transfer coefficient as 3900 watt per meter square Kelvin. Later, it is found water is not clean and has a fouling factor of 0.001 meter square Kelvin per watt. Find out the decreased overall heat transfer coefficient. And the options are 454 watt per meter square Kelvin, 688 watt per meter square Kelvin, 796 watt per meter square Kelvin, and D, none of these. Coming to solution, here we have a formula for fouling factor, and which is given by fouling factor is equal to 1 by u dirty minus 1 by u clean. That is, u dirty represents the heat transfer coefficient decrease due to the dirtiness of the water because of non-cleanness of water, and u clean represents the heat transfer coefficient for the cleaned water, and fouling factor is given by 0.001, and which is equal to 1 by u dirty minus 1 by u clean, that is heat transfer coefficient of clean water is given by 3900 watt per meter square Kelvin, and here we can find out the decreased heat transfer coefficient for dirty water is equal to 796 watt per meter square Kelvin, and in the options the correct answer is 796 watt per meter square केल्विन। ए डोमेस्टिक रिफ्रिजरेटर एक्सट्रैक्ट्स हीट फ्रॉम ए रिजर्वायर एट द टेम्परेचर ऑफ द ट्रिपल पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर एंड रिजेक्ट्स हीट टू ए रिजर्वायर एट द टेम्परेचर ऑफ नॉर्मल बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर इफ हीट लीक्स इनटू द फ्रीजर एट ए कंटिन्यूस रेट ऑफ 3.5 किलो जूल पर सेकेंड व्हाट इज द लीस्ट पावर नेसेसरी टू मेंटेन द ट्रिपल पॉइंट टेम्परेचर इन द रिजर्वायर। द ऑप्शंस आर 3.5 किलो वाट, 0.367 किलो वाट, 1 किलो वाट, 1.28 किलो वाट। कमिंग टू द सोल्यूशन हियर द लोअर टेम्परेचर एंड अपर टेम्परेचर ऑफ द रिफ्रिजरेटर आर गिवेन बाय लेट अस से T1 इज द मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर ऑफ द रिफ्रिजरेटर विच इज गिवेन बाय नॉर्मल बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर। नॉर्मल बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर इज नथिंग बट बॉइलिंग पॉइंट ऑफ वाटर एट नॉर्मल कंडीशन दैट इज एट एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर। That means the boiling point of water at atmospheric pressure is given by 100 degree centigrade and which is equal to 373.15 Kelvin. And coming to the triple point of water is given by 0.01 degree centigrade and which is equal to 273.16 Kelvin. And here heat leaks into the freezer at a continuous rate of 3.5 kilojoule per second. That means you will have to provide a refrigerant effect of 3.5 kilojoule per second. That is here refrigerant effect is given by 3.5 kilojoule per second or 3.5 kilowatts. And ideal COP is given by T2 by T1 minus T2. And which is equal to 273.16 by 373.15 minus 273.16 and is equal to 2.73. And also ideal COP is given by the refrigerant effect by minimum work input or minimum power input, which is we have to calculate. Minimum power input and which is equal to 2.73, so that the P minimum is given by here refrigerant effect is 3.5 kilowatts and COP is 2.73 and is equal to 1.28 kilowatts and the option is D is the right answer. The area under indicated diagram of an Otto cycle is given as 12.5 kilojoule with a compression ratio of 8. The swept volume of cylinder is 0.25 meter cube. Determine the indicated mean effective pressure of the cycle. And the options are 50 kilopascal, 25 kilopascal, 12.5 kilopascal, and 6.25 kilopascal. Here indicator diagram is nothing but the PV diagram of Otto cycle and we can draw it as on PV coordinates. Let us say 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 1 to 2 is compression, 2 to 3 is heat addition process at constant volume, 3 to 4 is expansion at an adiabatic process and 4 to 1 is heat rejection again at constant volume. Here the area under indicated diagram represents the work done by the Otto cycle indicated mean effective pressure is given by the ratio of area of indicated diagram to swept volume, that is we can define mean effective pressure is also the ratio of work done by the cycle to swept volume and which is given by already we know that area of indicated diagram and is equal to 12.5 kilojoule and swept volume is given by 0.25 meter cube And the answer is 50 kilopascal. So here the option is A. A is the right answer.